Hey guys, in this lesson, we're going to create an Elastic Beanstalk application. I'm logged into AWS and I have navigated across to the Amazon Elastic Beanstalk console. We're going to deploy an application on Elastic Beanstalk. And to do that, what we need to do is click on Create Application first. Now here we have two options. We can either create a web server environment or a worker environment. So a web server environment is when we're actually going to be running a website, for example. So this is the web front end. If, for example, our application then needed to perform some processing of data that was submitted by our customers, for that we would need a worker environment. So within the application, we can create web server environments and worker environments. Now in this case, we're just going to create a web server environment. Now a couple of things you will need for this is, one, you do need to have a key pair. So in EC2, make sure you've got a key pair. Secondly, you will need to have an instance profile. Now we've already created those in the training courses, so it actually doesn't matter which one you use. If you have an instance profile that you can attach to your EC2 instance, that's fine. But those are actually requirements for the setup, even though we don't necessarily need them. So I'm going to give this an application name. I'm going to call this Web App 1. Scroll down and it's going to create an environment. So we have an application. Within the application, we have the environment. And this is the web server environment within Web App 1. It gives a name. I'm happy with that. Now we could set up our own domain name if we want to. So I could call this something like Digital Cloud App. Check the availability. It's available. All right, let's go ahead and use that as a custom name. Now I can choose the manage platform. So remember, this is a platform as a service solution, and AWS provides a variety of different application frameworks for us. I'll select Node.js. Now what it's going to do is it's going to default to using a sample application. That's fine. It's just going to be a very simple website. We just want to see this running. So I'll leave that as the default. We've now got these various different presets because we could be deploying a single web server or a highly available web server. We can use different types of pricing model like Spot as well, or we can customize. Now I'm just going to leave single instance, and it is free tier eligible. Click on next. Now in the old days, before they actually refreshed the whole console to what it is today, that was about it. You could literally just click a button and it was going to create the environment for you. But now it actually requires that we do a few things. Now one is that we need to select a service role. If you have used Elastic Beanstalk before, then you can use an existing service role and you'll see this name. If you have not used it before in this account, and no one else has in this account, then you can create a new service role by just selecting this option. And you can leave the name exactly as it is. Now, I have run Elastic Beanstalk applications before, so I'm going to use an existing service role. Now, even though I don't necessarily want a key pair, I do have to select one. And even though I actually don't want an instance profile, I have to select one. So I'll select the S3 read-only, which I created earlier on. So remember, the instance profile is just a way of assigning permissions to your instance. So if I wanted to provide access to S3, then I would attach an instance profile. In this case, I actually don't want one. However, it does error if I don't select one. Same with the key pair. Now let's click on next. There's a few more screens we need to go through. We can launch in our custom VPCs if we wish to. I've only got a default VPC at the moment in this particular account, so I've selected that one. I can now choose whether I want a public IP. Yes, I do want a public IP, and I can select one or more subnets. So one is fine in this case because it's just an individual instance. If I was to do a highly available one, then I might want to do 1A, 1B. I'll just select two anyway, and we'll see where it goes. We're not using a database. You can actually deploy a database as well, so we're not doing that at this stage. So we'll just scroll straight past all of those settings there. Click on next. I'll leave the defaults here for storage. CloudWatch monitoring, yep, that's fine. I don't need to change anything there. I'm going to select a security group that I have. You'll need to make sure port 80 is open in the security group you select, and make sure the security group is in the relevant VPC as well if you have multiple VPCs. For capacity, it's going to create an auto-scaling group with just one instance because we're not using a load balance deployment. So I'll just leave that as it is. Scroll down. Now you can select different instance types here. So for example, I could choose T2 Micro to make sure that I get a free tier instance for this application. I'll leave the AMI as it is. Click on next. For monitoring, I'm going to leave it on basic. Scroll down and I'm going to deselect the managed updates. So Beanstalk will apply updates automatically. It actually does require that you have the enhanced health reporting on. I'm going to switch these two off just to simplify things here. I don't need email notifications. I'm not worried about deploying updates at this point. So I'm just going to scroll all the way down, click on next. And we're just in the review now, so we can scroll down, make sure that we're happy with all the settings. I am, so I'm going to click on submit. So now it's going to launch the environment for us, and that will just take a few minutes. Once the environment is configured and deployed, then we should be able to navigate across to the domain name here, and we should see a splash screen for Node.js website. While this is happening, you can actually scroll down a little way, and under events, you can see some of what is actually happening. In EC2, we can see that we have a running instance, and that instance is going to run our website. So we can now see that it's actually in our account, so we can actually access this instance ourselves. If I scroll down and go to auto-scaling groups, we can see we have an auto-scaling group. So even though we only deployed one instance, it does create an auto-scaling group. And the good thing about that is it's going to ensure that there's always one instance running. So if that instance failed for some reason, then it's going to launch a replacement instance. So we know that's going to happen for us by virtue of the ASG. Coming back, I'm just going to leave this for a moment and wait until it's ready. And as I say that, there we go. It is actually ready. So I'm going to click on the domain URL here, and that takes me across to the splash screen for the Node.js application. So very simple exercise, but now we've got our application running. Now, just to help you navigate this console, in the middle here, we have the events. We've then got health. We switched off some of the settings here. As you can see, it does say enhanced health is disabled. We've got some logs. So you can actually request the log files for the instance, and it's going to display them here. For example, the last 100 lines. We've got monitoring. Again, there's different levels of monitoring. We can have basic or we could have the advanced monitoring. We've got alarms here that we can set if we wish to. Managed updates, which we turned off, but otherwise AWS would actually manage the instance by deploying updates to the platform. Now on the left-hand side, firstly, we've got configuration. So if you did need to make some changes to the configuration that you deployed, this is where you do it. You can see the various different options. We've got the service access, we've got the networking and database, instance traffic and scaling if we wish to switch to having multiple instances, and updates and monitoring. So if we change our minds and we want to enable that, then this would be the place to do it. On the left, you can also click on events. That takes you to basically just that screen there, health, logs, monitoring. We already looked at those. So that is a web application deployed using Beanstalk. Now up here, you can see we've got application versions. This is where if you deploy updates to your application, you'll see the numbered versions in here, and you can then actually sort of separately manage these and deploy them to your environments or even roll back to previous versions of your application. At the very top here on the left, you've got applications. Of course, we created an application. Remember, the application is essentially the container into which we then deployed our environments. And at the moment, we just have one environment. Now, in this case, I have finished with this environment. So what I can do is come in here and terminate the environment, copy the name from the top here, paste that in, and then terminate. After the environment has been terminated, you can go and delete your application. It's not going to cost you anything, the actual application, but you do have to wait until the environment is deleted before you're able to do that.